Excel has a number of autofill features related to dates, which are quite useful. So the most common one people know is if I've got a date, if I go to the bottom right corner, as I start dragging down, you'll see it starts filling in and it actually shows you that it's going to do every day. So I'm going to go to, let's say, there. So all that's done is added one day to everything. However, you may not always want that. So for example, sometimes I want to be able to show work days. So I want to go from Friday to Monday. So a way to do that, type in our date. Here you right click and I'm going to drag it down. And when I let go, it asks me what I want to do, fill in days, which would achieve that, or do I fill in weekdays? So when I click weekdays, you'll see it automatically goes up to Friday and goes to Monday. So where I find this very useful is if I'm working on something and I now need to do the next workday, it's a lot easier. Right click, drag down, and there we go. You can do the same thing with months. So if I've got that date here, right click, drag down, I can say full months, and you'll see it goes 1st of Feb, 1st of March, etc. We can do years, so again, right click, drag down, full years. We can also do weeks or bi-weekly or something like that. So the way we do that, I click on it, right click, drag down, and you'll see there's an option here called series. When I click on series, it gives you a few questions. It knows it's a date, day unit is a day, step value. I'm going to type in a 7 here. We could put a stop value in, but for now I'm just going to say okay. And you'll see we've now got dates 1 week apart.